What the hell? Three American pieces of shit. Of work. Welcome to the show.
Hey, Jarvis, thanks for that. Welcome to the show. Maybe in the future you'll leave the self-driven 18-wheelers alone and to yourself. Without further ado, let's get right into the action of this week's episode, Crash Course Corner number 2. First up, we're going to introduce the vehicle we'll be testing this week. Stay tuned.
What the fuck is this piece of shit?
American piece of shit.
Piece of shit.
American. Now let me get on with my TV show.
What the fuck are you doing on TV anyhow? You know I get calls from back home every fucking day? They think you were bitch!
I don't care for the opinions of Turin and Aquilonias. I am American TV star now.
Could have had the food and beverage job without going on television. You
wanted to be on TV, and I was a bad cook. Now enjoy the show.
Okay, well that was certainly interesting, and I know better from working with Jarvis than to step in the middle of an Italian beef. Or is it meatball? Technically, I guess it's kind of the same. Although there's multiple types of meatballs. So anyway, I'll leave the dietary stuff to the experts. We've got a big body, Crown Vic big V8 on air suspension. The first test up on our docket is the sprint bumps.
No air suspension, no sprint bump.
3, 2, 1, go!
Shitty American windshield. Little bump. Gonna send it. Fuck Joshua Kill.
Jarvis, why do you not use the air suspension on a test called sprint bumps? Anyway, after that bout with Joe Pesci, we gotta keep Jarvis happy. On to the next test where we hope Jarvis does use the air suspension is the slalom stairs. Stay tuned.
Stairs, not an escalator. Going to have to use the air suspension.
Go!
Let's see what this air can do. Close one. This is fucking pancakes. Easy Jarvis. Fuck.
Jarvis deployed a little bit of a strategy on that one. He kept it nice and low for the slalom portion of the course and then lifted it up for the stair challenge. I really was anticipating for it to struggle a bit more than it did. Maybe we gave the Crown Vic just a bit too much power. However, up next is the curb J-turn. The truck failed last week. Let's see how this big body V8 does.
Let's do this damn shit. Fuck Joshua Q. Oh, oh, oh.
3, 2, 1, go!
Damn, missed the curbs. Trying again. Fuck it, transfer. I forgot to engage the air suspension. Fuck it. Pasta stuck to the pot. That hurt. Curb G-turn complete, but I did it the wrong way. Easy Jarvis. American piece. Shit.
All right. What an episode. Thank you, as always, to Jarvis for doing the driving. I'm not too sure if we're going to deem that Crown Vic a failed J-turn. I have my opinion. I'd like you guys' opinions down below. However, let's run through the times. So the truck in the last episode completed the slalom stairs in a minute and 12 seconds. The slalom stairs in the lifted Crown Vic was a minute and 14. So he nearly beat that truck in his own domain in the off-road area. Now here's the real doozy. The sprint bumps in the truck ran a 101. So 1 minute and 1 second. The Crown Vic hit it in 46 and a half. 46 seconds, almost 47, smoking the truck. We maybe gave the Crown Vic just a bit too much horsepower, but Jarvis said he wanted to drive something a bit unique this episode, so we did it for him. Until the next episode, you guys stay safe and you stay tuned.